What's up, everyone? This is Scratch, and we are on Lava 4-1. That's level 4-1. This is actually episode number 4 of my Pip 100% walkthrough, and we just defeated the caves, the Galena caves or caverns, whatever they're called, and we are now in Lava Labyrinth, so we have levels 4-1 through 4-8 that we're going to go through. But real quick, we'll just kind of recap the achievements that we just nabbed in the other ones, so you can kind of keep up and see where we're at. I actually have 13 achievements unlocked. I have 7 left over. So the Lava Lodger is located. So everybody in Lava Labyrinth. And then the Lord Magmalith Mastered. So we're going to defeat the Magmalith in the Lava Labyrinth. And then we should be able to get all available weapons, all available upgrades in the weapon shop. I'm going to say is probably going to come in the next episode when we do the other two. So I think we're probably only going to get Lord Magmalith Mastered and the Lava Lodgers located. Those are probably the only two that we're going to grab in this video, but I'll try and buzz through these as quickly as I can and show you guys what we're after here. So let's get started with Lava 4-1. All right, here we are in Lava 4-1. So make my way through here. And there is a ton of little secrets in here that I'll try to find as many of as I can. I'm not sure how many we're gonna get through here, but I will show you exactly what I know be most of them. So we got our first villager. We can't hardly miss at all. Now this is a little tricky to do, but you just kind of float down there and it gives you a ton of those pixels. Make your way back up here, let that go by. It's very difficult to do that. You can hang on the wall here as long as you need to, but there's another one right up here. Now there is a secret up above here, so you want to make sure that you using your float to the best of your ability. And as soon as that goes, you just run through here. Now this is a little tricky, just kind of get here so you're over the edge or whatever. Wait till he's blowing on you there so you can get over and get the girl. Now, as soon as that first one goes, I just kind of... You only have a second that you can wait. And then I still got hit, but I made it up there, not too bad. These guys are a bastard, because if they blow you off here, you're done. Alright, so I always just fall down there and grab him, and then hopefully you can kind of jump back up like that. So that's our third villager, third and final villager. That to go and get him, and then I would just immediately jump. It doesn't matter if you get hit or not, because messing around there is gonna be just a pain. So then it gets pretty easy here. Push these all the way to the end. Oops. And then you have to float. And you're in the bitstream. And that's it for stage 4-1. We got all three villagers. We got 1,470 pixels, which is a pretty good haul for just one level. And we got a perfect. So we're on our way. All right. Here we are in Lava 4-2. It's starting to get a little bit more difficult, especially with this lava. If you touch it one time, you are dead. Forget about it. Just like I said before. And it's definitely taking its toll. So I'm going to show you this here. I'm not even going to bother to go for it. Yeah, I am. It's a little bit tricky to get. It doesn't give you that much. But anyways, that's one of the secrets there. So there's our first villager. And we make our way through here. This is our second. This is where that magnet comes in handy, because you can stand here away from the bomb, or away from the meteors, or whatever they are. And you don't have to worry about being hit, which is nice. And you can still collect everything. Okay, so we're gonna move our way back over here. Take your time through here. This is not easy. And then when you get all the way back big here, you can head back over to the left. And we can get our second villager. Not so bad. I'm just gonna switch over to this guy because he's a little quicker. I'm actually gonna switch over to Pip, because then that thing doesn't sink quite as quickly, and it's a little less stressful. Okay, so we have a villager in this level, which is actually super easy to get. Just go all the way back down, and there we have it. So that one wasn't too bad. Then we'll just get as big as we can. There you have it. Okay. Now, this part. This. And then we'll ride this all the way down. Actually, maybe, yeah, okay. Get me. Okay, so I died in this room last time, but I'm hoping that I should be able to get through it. The bitstream is right here. And we're good. I didn't get that last treasure, but that's okay. We got a stage clear, 760 pixels with the perfect rating. So that's it for stage 4-2, and we are on our way to 4-3. Here we go. This one should not be too awfully bad. There's only a few parts that are just a little bit tricky, but for the most part, we can do it. So there goes our first save. And it's worth probably jumping on these, because they do give out a fair amount of health and pixels. Remember, the heavier you are, the faster they'll fall, which can be good and bad. There's a secret here that we want to make sure we get. Alright, now we'll float over here and then down here. I would just turn into the biggest guy here, and it makes this getting a little bit easier. It makes getting through here a little bit easier, and then you can actually just kind of go that way there. And here we go. So this part right here, so this part right here is where we're going to have our second villager. If you're using one of those villager finders, though, you won't ever find it, because you actually have to go into the next level before it would work. So this is the secret that takes you over here. There you have it, your second villager. Because that only alerts in the room that the villager is in, and so you wouldn't even get into the room the villager's in until you got right there. So this is an important one. So we're gonna, now we can just move this again and make our way right up here. So this gets a little tricky right there. Almost forgot to derez. Alright, so we made our way there. Go down and get this, it's not a big deal. Make our way right here. Right here. Want to collect as many of these as we can. See, there is my last villager to get, which we can get by doing this right here. And that is all three villagers, and now we just need to make sure we can get uh, Bitstream, and there you have it. That is a stage clear with another perfect. Got another 1260. And we're on to the fourth stage. We're halfway through this episode. But before we go any further, I have enough to buy some of those upgrades, so I'm going to go back and get the first one that's available. Alright, so we're back here, and I'm going to go to the Weaponsmith. And I want to buy something. I have the 5700, so I can get this Heavy Gloves. So I can crush blocks at my second evolution, which is actually, I think, going to be a huge advantage. So now I just need to get 8,000 or 6,500 to get the Cerberus. When I have full health, I cast a mighty blast towards my enemy with the swords, and then the power ring. They're only going to deal half damage to me. So we will get that shortly, but for now, we're just going to call it good. Alright, we're in level 4-4, and we'll see what we can do to collect all of the villagers here. There we have it. New dynamic here, and this is really difficult, but I managed to get through that part, okay. So we're gonna wanna swap back down here. Stay here, and we get our first villager there. Now here's another dynamic. In addition to the rising lava, now you have these guys that can make the lava harmless for a short period of time, which is awesome. But it's also kind of difficult. Okay. So made it through there. And this is actually going to combine both of those elements right here. And it gets a little bit tricky, so we'll give this one a shot. Alright, so this neutralized lava also rises here, so that makes it a little bit more tricky to kind of keep track of. And then we can walk right into here. I would just leave this on. Nope, you can't do that. Okay. So you gotta stay at least this level. Alright, so we're gonna hold her here. So here we go, and we save this pixel right here, and then what you're going to want to do is just go here and die. So I'll show you why you wanted to die here in just a second. It'll all make perfect sense here in just a moment. So after you die, it still counts as though you've gotten the villager. So, oh, that was not good at all. So it still counts that you get the villager, and then when you come here, you can get this villager, because the other way will bring you up here from the bottom, and then there's absolutely no way you can jump back over there. So this villager is actually missable, because you can't jump over there. But if you die, if you collect that last villager and die and then go back, you'll be in good shape. Then you have to make a beeline and run on this one. So wait for this to start to go down. And we are in the bit stream, and that is level 4-4 is complete. We've got 1500 pixels and all three of the villagers for a perfect. So now we just have 5, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and 8. So just a couple left. So the timing here is essential. And what your character is also is essential. Just one little death there, so I'll just leave it in because I'm not too far behind. But the timing of this is critical, because getting on these guys really definitely can slow you down. And so maybe if you timed it so that those spouts or whatever were down, it might be a little bit easier. See how easy it was for me to die there. So we're just gonna wait for these to go down. And then we wait for these to be up. And we're gonna go boom, boom, boom. And then right up here is our first villager. I don't need, normally I'd have to be level 3, but I don't need to be level 3 because I've already bought the upgrade to allow me to do that. Just make our way through here. Oops, I almost did do good there. Alright, so our next one is right here. You just want to be careful you don't fall in, because those things will drop you in the lava. And that can be a little tricky. Alright, made our way all the way there. Now this is probably the hardest part right here. So you need to jump and jump and jump. And jump and just have to move quick because the lava is actually coming up behind me. And once we get up here, we are home free. But I'll wait. You can see that lava is rising, and it rises pretty quick. If you don't stay ahead of it, you're not going to make it out of there without being burnt. So that is a perfect rating in level 4-5. So we will move on to 4-6. All right, here we are in level 4-6. So we'll jump in here and we'll see what we can come up with. And hopefully I don't die. Okay. Fairly straightforward there, and it looks like E, okay. We're just gonna take our time. Okay, so we blow that up there. We got our first. I would actually need to be able to break those open to get. Alright, quick death. We're jumping back in here. Like I said a minute ago, the little fireballs are really annoying. So I'm hoping I didn't miss anything here. All right, that's really good. I think I'm stuck. Nope. I was. Alright, and there's our second. Oops. Okay, we got two. We need one more. It's kind of nice having the pip that can so I don't have to you know, be in the third stage to break stuff. That's actually it's a good thing to get, I think. All right, and there's my last guy there. Jump over. Okay, so we have all three on this one. And I gotta devolve completely. And now we play the don't die game. Which I'm not doing too bad at right now. He jumps a little farther, that's why I did that. So that is level 4-6, and we're all done with that one. So we only got 400, but we're in the bitstream with all three characters, and we got a perfect on this stage. And so we are on to 4-7 now. Only two more left. We are in level 4-7. Here we go. Hopefully I can do okay here. There is a secret right here in the very beginning. And then this part's actually pretty easy. But this next part is difficult. Because if you get hit, I only got hit a little bit, but it's pretty tough right there. Alright, so this one we're going to go all the way down. So getting back is actually really tough. So right before you walk off the edge, jump and hold it. That's how you do that. So we got another one there. These are really spewing out some pretty serious pixels in this level. All right, quick death, but first thing we need to do is jump here, this way. We need to go up and over. I think I got her though, but I died. So that's gonna count, so I'm gonna have to leave this death in there. But as long as you touch her, you're good. And so that is one that I got. And then now we can go all the way up here to the top and we're in good shape. So that's the first one that I've gotten. I feel like there's the second one. Perfect. So I had to punch the wall there. So there is number two. Just for good measure, I want to kill him. All right. Alright, so we're gonna make our way through here. The first thing I'm gonna do is come over here and get big, I hope. And then I'm gonna jump back over here because this will actually give me quite a few. You can see how far up the lava goes. And then you can drop down when you know you're safe. And there's our third character right there. Just gonna wait for this guy to walk back by. All right, made it through that one, and we are at the bitstream, and I've got three left, so I didn't make that in time, obviously. We need to make our way all the way up here. All we have it. So that's it. So that's level 4-7. We're finally done with that one. And we've got a whopping 1,800. We got all three of the villagers. And it looks like we are on our way to another perfect. Okay, so we're starting off here in level 4-8. Hopefully this isn't too difficult, but we are going to actually fight the last boss here, which should be a little bit interesting. Okay, here we are in level 4-8. This is the last one, and we just have a little bit of looking to do, make our way through here. And hopefully we don't do any dying. Alright, here we are in 4-8. This is our last level that we have, and hopefully we can make our way through here. And not die. Alright, we are in level 4-8. Oops. Got hit there. So we'll make our way through here and see just what we have to do. We're gonna have to fight the final boss. This is gonna finish out this series that I have, and then hopefully we don't have too much trouble. But we'll see. Just gotta ride these guys over. Collect as many of these as we can. Keep our eye out for villagers. I feel like there's probably no villagers here. I did manage to see that. We can actually get over here from. See, if I jump out there. Oh, I kicked too. Alright, we're gonna have to wait. Because I wanna time it just correctly with those right there to be going down. Because I want to just be able to kind of run all the way over and not have to mess around. Okay, so we have a villager right here below me. So how are we going to get that? All right, so we got her. And we died. So that death doesn't matter, the villager is still collected, so if you do end up dying there, that's no problem at all. You can just do that, and it's easy to get through. So we'll just go ahead and leave that death in there. And it shows that I am actually human. Alright. Alright, we gotta get small. I knew there was a ledge there from when I was dropping down. But we get small and there's our other... There's our other villager, a second villager. We are not doing too good in terms of life. So I'm gonna go ahead and need to hopefully get something here soon. We are in fact going to grab these, but I'll have to go back up. They're just worth a lot and we need a lot, so I am taking the extra time to get them. Oh, and don't land on that. So I'm taking the extra time to get all of these because I think it's important. We have our third villager over there, so that should be pretty easy to grab. But we just need to make sure that we don't necessarily die here or land on this. Oh, yes, of course. So we're just gonna grab these chests because they're worth a lot of money and they're important to have, so we're just gonna keep grabbing them as best I can. And then right here I'm gonna change and not run fast enough. Alright, so we're gonna grab all these if we can, hopefully not die. We can wait right here. Oh. Yep. Okay, and then down here we have to run across this false area, so that's kind of a big deal. And then we wanna grab this ledge here, and oops. That was pretty scary. Okay, so now we need to make our way back up. And we are all the way up and we're good. All right, so that's all three and it looks like we are headed down to the boss. So we'll see what I can get done. Okay, here we are in 4-8, and we're gonna turn down into a single pixel. And we just kinda hang out over here on the left. And you're gonna he's gonna miss you most of the time. Occasionally, like right here, you may have to move once or twice, but for the most part, you can hide there, and then that swing is also gonna miss you. And then you get this, and then you get big, and then head straight to the middle. And keep jumping, push that off, back to a pixel, and we're safe. So just stay there. He shoots these again. And he's gonna swing and miss again. So we jump on his head. Now this is the tricky part. You want to stay towards the middle. But I just switch to a pixel. And then this time I just keep jumping. Don't bother trying to push that off because it's next to impossible to do it. I probably should have gone over to the right to give myself room, but it's okay, we can run over here. So this time we can just wait. He swings. And this time we've got him. The trick is don't push that one off because it's basically too far away to get it. And so if you just keep jumping as a single pixel, you'll be able to keep it up. And this is really easy to do. You won't see the achievements pop here because I've already completed this and accidentally deleted the video, but this does give you a perfect, and if you've been following the guide, you're gonna have no trouble. And they should be popping. So I'm just gonna show you real quick. We'll snap the achievements. I have the game completed now, but I didn't when I originally did this. But the two that we got here were Lava Lodgers Located, which has rescued all the villagers in the Lava Labyrinth, and then defeated Lord Magmalith in the Lava Labyrinth. So those are the two that you should have gotten right here if you've been following the guide. And that's all I've got for this. So thank you guys for watching, and I will catch you in the next video. You're almost there.